Whether you're looking to fix a broken optical drive, or maybe you want to swap it out for a hard drive enclosure with an SSD, the process is actually pretty easy, and it should only take you about an hour. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you how to replace the optical drive in a non-unibody MacBook Pro. There were several iterations of this computer released between 2006 and 2008, so while this video is a great overview of the process, you'll still want to look up the step-by-step instructions for your specific model of computer on our site before you get started, because there are subtle differences in the repair process. The model number is located on the underside of your MacBook Pro, but if it's rubbed off, you can head to the ID Your Mac page on our site and look it up that way. Before I get started, I'm going to get all of my parts and tools together, which really isn't a whole lot. All I'm going to need is a plastic spudger, a Phillips 00 screwdriver, a T6 Torx driver, both of which I got from our 26-piece bit driver kit, and my replacement optical drive, or a hard drive enclosure if that's the route that you're going. I'm also going to have my very favorite organizational tool handy, a screw tray, because there are lots of teeny tiny screws involved and I want to make sure to keep them all organized. Now that I've got all of my parts and tools together, I can get started by flipping the computer over and removing the battery. Once the battery's out, we're going to get to work on removing the top case. And in order to do that, we have to remove the memory cover. Once the memory cover's out, we'll be able to see all the screws on the bottom that we have to take out in order to get the top case off. With the last of the bottom screws removed, I can get started removing the ones along the sides. You really want to make sure to consult the repair guide at this point because they tend to blend in and you want to make sure you remove all the necessary screws before you start pulling the case off. Now that all the screws around the perimeter are removed, the next step is to take off the top case. So you're going to flip the computer over and open it up and begin to pry the top case off near the screen of the computer, rotating it back towards the front of the computer. When you get to the front, there's going to be some latches that you need to release, and that's when the spudger comes in handy. Okay. When you get that last clip released, don't go pulling the whole thing off just yet because it's still attached to the logic board via a ribbon cable. So what you want to do is lift it up gently and disconnect that ribbon cable with your spudger. Once that ribbon cable is disconnected, this whole piece just comes right off and the bulk of our repair is complete. You can see the optical drive now, and all that's standing in our way is a ribbon cable and some screws. So I'll go ahead and take care of those now. Once those screws are out and this cable is disconnected, the optical drive should just slide right out. The only thing that's left for me to do is transfer these brackets and the cable over to my new drive. So I'll go ahead and take those off now. Now all I've got to do is attach that cable and those brackets to my new optical drive and reassemble my computer. You can find all of the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at ifixit.com. And if you run into any problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions in the answers section of our site. For all the latest teardowns and repair videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel and check us out on Twitter at twitter.com/ifixit. Thanks for watching and happy repairing!